Sensation 3.0, the EDM and drumstep vocalist Zombie Supreme. Okay, we're about to get it started, percolating, all of that. Yes. Now you know what we're here for, folks. You know what we're here for, don't you? All right. Boop. Yes. Welcome. This is some good stuff here, y'all. You had me at Wolf, okay? Yes. We want to get into the wonderful news today. So sit back, relax. Will Daft Punk actually return to the scene? Stay tuned and find out. Because they be pulling Houdini. They want to come in. They want to go away. They want to retire like a Jay-Z. Come back. Retire. Honey, ain't nobody got time for it. If you want to retire, are you not? This is Peyton 3.0. EDM World News. YouTube and TikTok. Here we go. Well, not that. Here we go for real. So, before we get to the wonderful news, let's go ahead and get to, I want to eat this today. Let's go ahead and get to the social media. So, you know, I got to promote myself, okay? And for those of you who don't know, once again, like I told you, the tagline is EDM Vocalist Zombie Supreme. I am an EDM music vocal artist, rap, sing, all of that. So here we go. That's what I mainly am. I'm kind of doing YouTube on the side to get more eyeballs on me. Anyway, people always told me I should have my own show anyway. So that's what I'm trying to do in my own niche of community. So anyway, the first one, page number one, if no one ever comes up, put me Merc into number two. Make sure YouTube number two, you like, comment, subscribe, hit that notification. KK Bell, all of that, okay? Share with your friends who are in the community of EDM. Hashtag floor, okay? sessionslive.com/Peyton3062. Now, that is a place where you can see me perform live cover songs and mainstream hits, or if you want to hear some EDM classics or whatever, and I know them, I'll sing them for you if that's you're interested in that. Major American hits, whatever. Website is Peyton30.com. I work hard on that website, so please do visit it. SoundCloud.com/Peyton30. You'll find a hint of my music on there. Instagram.com/Peyton3_0star. My Instagram obviously needs a lot of help at the time of this recording because it's just hard for some people to thrive on Instagram, right? There was a beautiful woman, honey, right? Curves all that, right? Made a little white skin, maybe, depends. I might get a lot more traction, but that's not the case, okay? Facebook, just being honest, Facebook.Zombatron community, Facebook.com/Peyton30, TikTok, Peyton3_0, which those of you on TikTok, you know what you gotta do. All right, if you have not subscribed to my TikTok, shit, this video, you're in the EDM community, please come on over and press follow. Thank you. Give the video lots of likes. Because TikTok is now 10-minute videos, so that's a great thing. How much time are we on right now? I can't wait to see the count. 5 minutes. Anyway, let's get into the news. So, turn. And if the frames are skinny because I'm in OBS, that's all right. That's all right. We're going to continue as long as you can hear me. Great. That is all that matters. I got to fix this crap. For some reason, it just went out of whack. But that's all right. We want to do this, okay? So, all right. Daft Punk returned to social media. Sparked comeback rumors on 1 year anniversary of the split, okay? And I'm sure everybody's up to date on what's going on with this. So Daft Punk announced a one-time only live stream of their 1997 Dafton Direct Tour concert in Los Angeles, recorded without their iconic helmet. Okay? So if you guys haven't seen that, and I might try to pull it up on this particular show here later on, so we can see them who they really look like. All right. And for those of you on TikTok, this video will be longer than 10 minutes. If you want to see the full show, you're going to have to come over to youtube.com/C/ Peyton 30 covers hits and subscribe to see this video in full. I guess TikTok is going for long form like a YouTube. They want to become everybody. They want to eat everybody for dinner. That's what TikTok is trying to do. Okay, we'll see how they go. We'll see how it goes. They get on Mark Zuckerberg, everybody else, and people follow to YouTube and run for their money, so we'll see. But anyway, they got competition in the waters. Oh, Daft Punk, why are you doing this to us, right? On the 1 year anniversary of their shocking split, the legendary electronic music duo have returned to social media. The resurrection was, of course, cryptic in nature. But it wasn't long before Daft Punk announced a rare live stream of a helmetless show in 1997, folks, okay? It all started today after Daft Punk's verified Instagram account shared an image reminiscent of their debut album, Homeward, but refrained from including a caption, okay? The robots also launched a Twitch channel, okay? Which was immediately verified, honey. Just like that, they said, chat, we know who you guys are. We have the clock. They said, hold on, this is a real Daft Punk? Okay, great, chat. All right, the page is listed as the official Twitch channel of Daft Punk, right? They also created a Twitter account. Now, let me just start right there. I don't know, maybe some of you guys like Twitter, you're on Twitter. There's a specific audience for Twitter. I have a Twitter account. I haven't really used it in a couple years because I don't really care for Twitter. It's not my thing. That's why I don't have a Twitter. I have an account, but I'm not going to list it here because I'm not active on it. So it's not important to me, right? Comment below if you like Twitter, why you like Twitter. What does it do for you? Because it does nothing for me. Let me just be clear about that, okay? Alright, so. And that Daft Punk post got about 365. No, I think it's 365. 625,000 likes. But it's Daft Punk, so that's not surprising. Less than an hour later, Daft Punk posted an old flyer from the Los Angeles stop of Dafton Direct Tour, the duo's first ever concert tour, which spanned from January to December of 1997. Okay? The fabled performance took place at the Mayan Theater on December 17th of the year. Okay? This post naturally led many to believe that a reunion tour is in the works. So you see how people play with you, they'll stir around, Let's take Rihanna, for example, for those of you who know Rihanna. She keeps teasing a new album. It's coming out. It's coming out soon. But honey, a year has passed, ain't nothing coming. 2 years have passed, ain't nothing coming because she's not focused on that, okay? See, people who have a large fan base, folks, people who have, who are legends, they have all these followers, a dedicated super fan base, that's gonna be there while they're gone for 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, they still there, their mouths are dropping, watering, waiting patiently for the return, even if it's hopeless and delusional, right? So what the artists will do, they're smart, they'll capitalize off of that. They'll post something on the social media now, you know, that it's here. And they'll tease, but they'll be cryptic about it, right? They'll mislead you to think they're coming back. Oh, come out of retirement. Oh, wait, come out of retirement? The point of retirement is to actually retire and not come back. But they pull this kind of stuff all the time. Jay-Z. Whoever else. Okay. They come back out of retirement. Oh, come back out of retirement. Boop. New album. Right? These are all marketing ploys. Marketing tricks. The old retirement marketing ploy. Right? To generate new and excitement. Right? For the artists. So, let's continue. Comment below if you think that this is a legit thing. That Daft Punk is really coming back. They're planning a tour. They're planning an album. Or do you think they're not really coming back? They're just pulling our legs. Or people are just misconstruing what's being said on social media. Okay? So let's have a discussion down in the comment section. Let's continue. Okay? A press release was then shared with BDM.com announcing a one-time only live stream of a Daft and Direct Tour LA show on Twitch, which has since concluded. The remarkable footage showed Daft Punk's guy Manuel Dehome, I'm sorry, I can't pronounce that word, Christo and Thomas Bang Ultra without their iconic helmets. Okay. Okay, gotcha. Gotcha. That's the name. That's the names. Okay. Daft Punk also announced a vinyl reissue of Homework in celebration of the semi-annual 25th anniversary. Okay. The Homework vinyl LP, along with a vinyl reissue of Alive 97, is set to release on April 15th and can be pre-ordered on February 22nd here, which today is actually not February 22nd, it's actually March 1st today, 2022, so it's already out for pre-order if it's not out already. Well, are you really a big fan of Daft Punk? I mean, I'm assuming that you're a fan, big fan of Daft Punk if you clicked on this particular video, or you just love me and you like to support me, and I thank you very much. But with that being said, I forgot to mention the song in the background for those of you who are not my regular followers and watch my videos or my new show on this channel. The song in the back is called When I'm Alone Is the Best Time, written, vocal produced by me, but actually produced by DJ Dead Nasty. Okay? You can get that by going to my website and getting on my email list, okay? I need people on my email list that are serious about the EDM music, about dubstep, drum and bass. I need you on my email list. And I'll put the social media's back up at the end of this. But right now, we're getting back into it. Are you going to get the vinyl? Just comment below, okay? And let's comment below. What is this you ask? Don't ask. Okay, anyway. Let's comment below what Daft Punk means to you. And what kind of memories do they hold for you? What kind of memories do they bring back when you think of Daft Punk? Okay? Now, Homework 25th Anniversary Edition will also gather for the first time remixes released in 1997 by Masters at Work. Roger Sanchez and Junior Sanchez, Todd Terry, and Moda Bates, among others. Check out the track list, okay? Yes. Yes, let's see the track list here. The first up on this one, the original album, Dabden Direct. Track two is WDPK 83.7 FM. Track three is Revolution 909. Def. Four is Defunk. Five is Phoenix. Six is Fresh. Seven is Around the World. Eight is Rolling and Scratching. Nine is Teachers. 10 is High Fidelity. 11 is Rock and Roll. 12 is Oh Yeah. 13 is Burning. 14 is Endo Silver Club. 15 is Alive, Honey. Yes. And 16 is Funk Ad. Okay. And then you have a bunch of the remixes on the second disc. Okay. Comment below if you know any of these songs, if you're a real Daft Punk fan, and why do you like this song? Is it the production? This is the way that it makes you feel? When you with your girlfriend or boyfriend for the first time, at your first rave? I don't know. Comment below. Okay? Yes. All right. It's too soon to read the tea leaves beyond the stream in vinyl, but fans are already tearing hell for leather into the rumor mill, okay, as they should. Or should they? All right. There's a tweet on here that says a Daft Punk reunion with a question mark. Okay. And then there's somebody wrote on the post, don't be an NFT. Don't be an NFT, right? Don't be an NFT, Daft Punk, on this one. Okay? Daft Punk retired a year ago today. It's literally 2/22/22 at that time. If they announced a tour, this is from Jack Williams. If they announced a tour, I will go rancid, he says. Like, I don't think y'all understand, he says, how much this group means to me. I've been listening to them since I was 11. That's what he says. That's from Jack Daniels and Twitter. All right. But yeah, so Daft Punk supposedly making their return. What do you think? Is it real? Is it make-believe and fairy dust? Right? We don't know. Are you excited for the album? Maybe I don't. Go ahead and comment down below. Make sure you like, subscribe, comment, share. Hit that notification bell, right? This has been Pate 3.0 EDM World News. The EDM and drum step vocalist Zombie Supreme. But you know, before we go, I gotta put the social media up one more time for you. So here we go. All right. Like I said, the first YouTube, just ignore that. Okay, because that one's going away. It's going to be YouTube number two from YouTube. That's the one you want to focus on. For those of you on TikTok, which you actually, if you're on YouTube, well, by now you obviously won't be on YouTube because you won't be seeing this part on TikTok because it will not be there. TikTok only allows 10 minutes now for a longest video. Like I said, they're probably trying to become YouTube in some kind of way. Trying to compete with YouTube now. They're coming for everybody's necks, okay? TikTok's coming for my asses. But anyway. SessionsLive.com/Pate3662. my website, so you can get on my email list. Come on, folks, get on that email list. It gets all the culture. You want to get to my music, you know, all of that. See me live stream and all that other stuff. All of the perks and goodies. Got some merch eventually. To get on my email list, like going to the website, or going to get the free unreleased songs at the bit.ly link, okay? SoundCloud, Instagram, you see it, Facebook, you know, TikTok, and of course YouTube, number two, which is the channel we're on right now. For those of you that are here, make sure that you, like I said, subscribe. Alright, so folks, thank you so much for being here, staying to the very end. That means you were entertained by my crazy ass. This has been Peyton 3.0, the EDM and drumstep vocalist, Zombie Supreme, and I will see you on the next video. Bye-bye now. That's not right, I'm sorry. Bye-bye now.